has gone straight into the back. It'll trigger a safety car, and that is a disastrous start that everybody would get around.
Control to all teams, advise your drivers. Control to all teams, advise your drivers. Due to the impact on the front grid, all cars to pit lane, please. All pit lane.
And similarly, the Thomas Randall car, not in very good shape. So an awkward and awful way to get things started, unfortunately, out there for us.
So you watch this, he moves, and then he moves again, and that's when it stalled. That's probably close enough to 150 kilometres an hour, I reckon.
Okay, so... somebody else deal with what comes next, track condition-wise. Oh, this is an arc. Oh, bad rejoin. And another huge incident on the exit of the chase.
Safety car on standby.
And so this is going to be a disaster. Zane Goddard has driven back out on the road with 30 tyres and clean bowl a heap of cars, including Winterbottom, including car number 8, Dale Wood, and one of the Penrite cars in this. It's an unbelievable scene.
So this is Goddard. Down the inside, he's locked a wheel, trying to get by Greg Murphy. Now he's straight on, he's into it. He's in the throttle and he's emerged back on, out of control, nowhere for them to go. That is a massive shot. And seriously, here we go. Oh my God, that is a massive shot. Had nowhere to go, completely locked out. The reaction from everybody down there at Grove Racing.
And he's got 0.6 of a second over Davison. That's a nice cushion to get things started. Brody up in the third.
Oh, monster crash!
High. Now, he's had big ones here before, and he's gone heavily to the inside wall. This will trigger the BP Ultimate safety car. And sadly, the Newlon car, huge damage. Now, let's have a look further back in the pack to understand who did what to who. Okay, so the other car there was a Matt Stone racing car, but I'm not sure which of them
Jack,
it was.
Jack LeBrock.
You reckon?
Yep.
So here we go. Yeah, you're right. Car number 34. So he's moved to the right. Pye's moving to the right, moving to the right, moving to the right until there's contact.
Seriously. You just can't do that stuff. It's fine. It's fine when you're driving alongside each other to be making contact like that, but that is a seriously damaged motor car at an absolutely... you know, high-speed area of 200 kilometres an hour, and at any point that accident doesn't happen if you don't make contact. You don't go off the road without some help.
So meaning Scott going to the right.
Well, Scott was going to the right, but right at the end of it, you've still got a duty of care to come out of the throttle.
So that's the onboard view, and it just went on and on and on and on and on.
And turned it left.
So you got Scott going to the right, you got Jack going to the left, and in the end you've got a bucket load of loose nuts and bolts at the end of pit lane there up against the concrete wall. That's going to be expensive, that one. And we've got a very tight turnaround to the next event. Then, monstrous trouble here.
Safety car boards and flags.
That is an extraordinary incident. There are cars everywhere. Golding's right in the centre of it. Courtney's backwards. Hazelwood,
flag,
Smith.
Red flag.
Slade in the middle of it. There's got to be 10 cars there, hasn't there?
So it starts with James Golding tripping over right here, gets it crossed up, launches across the top of the curb, lucky not to roll it, and that has had the effect of tripping over Randall, and then the rest of them are all doing 150 kilometres an hour and they drive smack bang into the middle of a gigantic mess. Oh, wow. And that's going to take some time to clean up. I think I can... say with a reasonable degree of confidence that all drivers are okay and out. Man. So James let go of the wheel and crossed his arms there. So that was a shocker. It's a great pile of cars all doing 150 odd kilometres an hour, just drive straight into the scene. So the Courtney car, it was lucky that thing didn't end up on its roof.
Yeah.
And then that's about where we picked it up, where there's a good 8 or so cars all just parked at varying angles. And this was perhaps the greatest concern. A bit of the messiness came from Di Pasquale in the middle of the road. Here we are at turn 10. Okay, yeah, he's just ended up
That's Ouch. A bell ringer.
My ribs are hurting just looking at it.
And then Nick Perkat's on the outside. It can be very dirty around there.
Oh, who's in the fence?
One of the truck assist cars has gone heavily into the wall down there on the exit of turn seven.
This will be safety car.
And Heimgartner's involved in it as well. This will trigger the safety car. We've had a low probability of the safety car in recent times, and this will bunch up the field.
Now, who contacts who? Now, Jack LeBrock and Heimgartner have made wheel-to-wheel contact, and then bang, off the road they go.
Yeah, so it's an interlock.
I think it is, isn't it?
Yeah, I think they've just ended up just jammed on each other's wheels. And so LeBrock just carting Heimgartner out there. He's actually gone in pretty heavily there. Thankfully, those tyres have done the job, and one of our marshals, I think, is also just trying to escape the scene, has tripped over the fence down there.
Back in the pack here significantly, so he's got on. He's gone in. Trouble, he's been turned and whacked the wall. Game over for Di Pasquale. Does he survive this? Just.
Left rear is broken.
Have a look at the damage on car 11. That is massively hurt. So on board now. So that's David Reynolds. And then a little bump with Heimgartner. And then on your right, you'll see Brody. We don't actually see him because he's just back behind the vision that we can show you. And I'm to your point, I thought the guys have done a great job to miss a spinning Anton Di Pasquale who was going to come back into the field. I thought for sure there'd be other cars that would collect him.
So it looked like Davison was going to escort them out there, and he's lost more ground there. Scott Pye's been able to get by. Oh, they're all in. Scott Pye's been hit. He's actually turned right back around. Have they all missed him? That's an absolute miracle.
Oh, man.
Is that Davison or Di Pasquale? One of them straight in the fence.
I think it's Will. So he was tangled in all that. There was contact on the exit of turn three.
But this is going to tell the story. So off turn three, little bump against the fence, and then contact between Will and Scott turned.
A bit more of the story. Scotty gets up there. Yeah, he did hit the curb, and that's what fired it out there. And then there's no space on the left-hand side. It's actually side of Shane, so he's going to give us a great view of this as well. There just was not space out there.
Davison hangs on just barely into turn two, and he makes a little mistake, and we've got Courtney in the wall. This is going to trigger a safety car.
He's caught with Hazelwood, I reckon. That's Hazelwood in behind. That was also Chris Pither.
Jake Kostecki might have been lurking around there as well, so that shows us the aftermath, doesn't really explain the source.
To go on the outside at turn five to displace Reynolds into the hairpin. He didn't get away with it. A car rotating violently in the middle of turn six, and it's clean bowled and skittled about four or five cars. Now, I think it was a WAU car that I saw rotating initially, or it might have been Courtney.
Boards and flags.
Safety car will be deployed. Massive damage to Courtney's car.
I caught it
out of the left side of frame. There was a car rotating on the grass in the braking area into the hairpin.
Does this tell more of the story?
But I think what's happened is it's so wet because of the moisture on the grass.
Race has been suspended. Race has been suspended.
And James Taylor, the race director, suspending the race until they can get all these cars recovered and the debris off the road. So
yes, he got a bump for sure, but then he's spinning, then you're out of control, and he's made contact with other cars in racing direction. So he's come straight across from turn four and has gone to five on the exit then of six, and the rejoin has made contact with a significant number of cars. That's why all those other cars were spinning off to the right-hand side on the exit of six.